This is the first video on Chapter 8 Motion. In this video, we will describe what motion is, we will see what motion along a straight line is, and we will learn about uniform and non-uniform motion. Also, this is the first physics lesson in your textbook, so make sure that you understand the concepts well rather than by-hearting anything. These chapters will form the fundamental basics you need throughout till class 12. In our day-to-day life, we come across different kinds of motion. A car moving on a road, a fan on the ceiling, a swing in the playground, or the planets in the solar system, all are in motion. But each of these are unique in the type of motion. They are not moving in the same way. With this difference in the type of motion, we classify motion into many, and we will learn about a few of them in this chapter. First, let us describe what motion is. An object is said to be in motion when its position changes with respect to time. That is, when you see that an object is at different positions as time passes by. Imagine an ant. You find that its position after a few seconds is somewhere here. Then you can say that the ant has moved. Now imagine that this ant was in a large field. When there is nothing around, you may find it difficult to understand its motion, right? When it's too small on a very large field, you will find it difficult to mark the initial and final positions of this ant. Now imagine that there was a tree somewhere here. Now, with respect to the tree, you can mark the position of the ant. Like, you can measure the distance from the tree, and you can mark its initial position, and after some time, say the ant was somewhere here, then you can mark the distance again, and you can define its final position. So with respect to the tree, you are marking the position of this ant. Now when you do so, you are using the tree as a reference object, and this reference object is called the origin. So the reference point, which is the origin, is any point or object in the surrounding which you use in order to specify or in order to describe the position of another object. You use it as per your convenience. It may be anything or points. For example, when you draw a number line, you take some point and mark it as zero. Then, with respect to this point, you mark other points on both sides of the number line. Similarly, you are using one specific point or object in order to describe the position of some other objects. This is called an origin. Now let's see what motion along a straight line is. Imagine an ant moving on a string which is tied at some height. This ant can move either forward or backward. It can't take any turns or move in any other direction. It is moving along this straight line. Such a motion is called a linear motion or a one-dimensional motion. Here, consider some arbitrary point, let it be this, as an origin. Now, you can mark the position of this ant by measuring the distance from this particular point. That is why it is called one-dimensional, because you need only one spatial dimension to define the position of this object. So, a one-dimensional motion is when an object moves along a straight line. It is the simplest type of motion. And other examples could be a car moving on a straight road, or imagine a coconut falling from this tree. As soon as the coconut leaves the tree, it travels in a straight line till it touches the ground. So this is another example of a one-dimensional motion. Now imagine a number line here. So the origin we chose, let's take it here. Now we will have the positive numbers here and the negative ones along this side. Hence, when you consider the motion of this ant along this straight line, you take the motion in one direction to be positive and the motion along the opposite direction as negative. Now, this is arbitrary. You can take it as per your convenience. So, the motion along one direction is taken as positive and the one in the opposite direction is chosen as negative. Now let's see what a two-dimensional motion could be. When the same ant moves on the floor, you need two dimensions, two physical dimensions in order to mark its position, right? So you can imagine the origin to be some corner, let this be the origin. And if you know the distance of the ant along this direction and the distance along this direction, you will be able to mark the position of this ant accurately. So with two distances, you can mark the position of the ant. Such a motion is called a two-dimensional motion. Now, what could be a three-dimensional motion? It is when you require three physical parameters to mark the position. For example, a fly which is flying in a room. You need three physical dimensions in order to mark the positions. With these three dimensions, you can mark its position. So, this is a three-dimensional motion. Now, imagine an ant is moving along some straight line. So, you are marking the distances at different points. And let the ant move from the origin to a point A and then it returns to the point C. So the ant has traveled from the origin O through C and B and reaches A and then takes a turn and reaches the point C. Now the total length of the path covered by this ant will be OA plus AC, right? Which is this length plus the length back. Now this is equal to, from the figure, it is 60 plus 35. Which is 60 minus 25, you get 35, which is 95 kilometers. Now, this path length is called distance. You know it. The total length of the path covered by this ant is called as the distance covered by this ant. Now, the distance traveled by this ant is 95 kilometer. Maybe too long for an ant, but it's just an example. Now, how far is the ant from its initial position now? That is, what is the distance between the initial and final positions of the ant? It's 25 kilometer. This distance is called displacement. It's a new term. The distance between the initial and final positions of an object is called displacement, which is 25 kilometer here. That is, the shortest distance measured from initial to the final position of an object is the displacement. Imagine this same ant has moved some path like this. It started from A and stops at B. What could be the displacement here? It is the shortest distance. So it should be a straight line which starts from the initial position, starting point A, and ends at B. This distance will be the displacement in this case. Now, distance is just a numerical value, and such a numerical value of a physical quantity is called as magnitude. Can distance and displacement be equal? It can. Imagine that this ant starts from O and stops at B. What is the distance here? It is 35 kilometer. Also, the displacement, that is the distance of final position from the initial position, it is also 35 kilometer. So the displacement is again 35. Hence, distance and displacement can be equal. Now, displacement can be zero, but distance cannot. If something moves, its position has to change. So, when the ant moves from this point to somewhere else, there is some distance it has moved. But in some other cases, there can be that the displacement is zero, but it has moved. For example, the ant, after moving to B, returns to the same position it started. Here, it has traveled some distance, way here and back, but the displacement it has undergone is zero, since the initial and final positions are the same. That is, if the initial and final positions are same, the displacement will be zero. Now, this is the case when a sprinter runs around a track, something like this. So the initial position, the start point, be somewhere here. After each lap he covers, the distance goes on increasing, but if the final position is the same as the starting position, the displacement is zero, but the distance is not. Now let's see what uniform and non-uniform motion is. Imagine that you are moving in a car on a straight road and you are measuring the distance covered in each second. You find that the car travels, say, 5 meters in each second. This is true for the entire journey, that is, throughout the journey, in each second, the car covers 5 meters distance. Such a motion is called a uniform motion. That is, when the body or the object covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. Here, the distance is 5 meters and the interval of time is 1 second. So, when an object covers equal distance in equal intervals of time, the motion is said to be uniform. For example, the hands of a clock. In each second, the second hand of a clock covers equal distance, right? So that is a uniform motion. And the fan running on the ceiling, when it travels at a constant speed, that is also a uniform motion. Now, what could be a non-uniform motion? Simply when the object covers unequal distances in equal intervals of time. That is, if the car had traveled, say, some 5 meters in the first second, but some 7 meters in the second second, and this goes on changing. So, if the distance covered is not the same for each time interval, such a motion is called a non-uniform motion. For example, when a car is moving on a crowded street or a busy traffic, you can't keep the speed same. You will have to slow down or increase the speed. Also, when a man is jogging, he won't be jogging at the same speed throughout his journey. So that is another example of a non-uniform motion. Now let's look at a few questions. An object has moved through a distance. Can it have zero displacement? Yes. We have seen this earlier, that if the initial and final positions are the same, the displacement will be zero, right? And an example could be when a man runs around a circular track, and if the starting and ending points are the same, then the displacement will be zero, right? Even though the distance is not. Now see the third question. Which of the following is true for displacement? It cannot be zero. Can displacement be zero? Yes, it can be. We are seeing this right now. So this is false. Its magnitude is greater than the distance traveled. We are seeing that displacement is the shortest distance between starting and ending points. So whatever path the body takes, displacement will be the shortest distance. So it cannot be greater than the distance traveled. So this is also false. Now see the second question. A farmer moves along the boundary of a square field of sight 10 meter in 40 seconds. That is, let this be the field and the side is 10 meter, right? So along the boundary the man takes 40 second. So what is the distance traveled here? It is 40 meter. One side is 10 meter. Let the man start from this point. So the distance traveled is 40 meter and time taken is 40 second. Now what will be magnitude of displacement at the end of 2 minutes 20 seconds from his initial position? Now so the man takes 40 seconds to travel 40 meter, right? Then how much will the man travel in 1 second? He will travel in 1 second, the man will travel 40 divided by 40, which is equal to 1 meter, right? Now we are given the distance 2 minutes and 20 seconds. 2 minutes 20 seconds can be written as 2 into 60 plus 20, right? Which is the same as 140 seconds. So from this position the man is running around this field along the boundary for 140 seconds. So in 1 second the man travels 1 meter, then in 140 second he will travel 140 meter, right? That is, from this position the man has traveled 140 meter around this field. How many laps will that make? That is, one lap around this field is equal to 40 meter, right? Then 140 meter will make 140 divided by 40, which is equal to 3.5 laps. That is, he will travel around this field 3.5 times. So first time he starts from here, he will end here. For the second time again, for the third time again, and then he will have to travel half the lap, which is he will be stopping here, right? So at the end of 2 minutes 20 seconds, the man will be in this point, right? Now, what is the displacement? Displacement is the shortest distance from starting and ending points. So this distance is the displacement. Now, how do you calculate this distance? It is the it is in this right triangle. This side is 10 meter and this side is again 10 meter. So using Pythagoras law, you can now to calculate this distance, you can use Pythagoras theorem. In this right triangle, you have this side 10 meter and this side 10 meter. So this side will be root of 10 square plus 10 square, which is root of 200, which is 14.14 meter. That is, at the end of 2 minutes 20 seconds, the displacement of the farmer is 14.14 meter. Now, this is the case if the man starts from this corner of the square. And this is the maximum displacement possible. If the man starts from somewhere on the edge, then at the end he will be in this position, right? In that case, the displacement will be 10 meter. So the maximum possible displacement is 14.14 meter and the minimum is 10 meter. Now that's all with the first video. In this, you have learned that motion is a change of position and it can be described in terms of the distance moved or maybe the displacement. Now here I had missed a point, that is the SI unit, the standard unit used for distance as well as displacement is meters, which is the SI unit of length, which is denoted by small letter m. And the motion of an object could be uniform or non-uniform depending on the distance it covers in a unit time. Now that term is called as speed or velocity, which we will cover in the next video. Thank you.